இப்படி பல்வேறு விஷயங்களில் நம்மோடு நின்று போராடிய மதிப்பிற்கு மரியாதைக்கு முறையே நம்முடைய புறவலர் பிருந்தா கரத் அவர்கள் நமக்கு சிறப்புரையாற்றுவார்கள்.
பிரியமான சகோதரிகளே, சகோதரர்களே, சம் சகோதரர் சகோதரர்களே, dear leaders of the Tamil Nadu State Committee, I want to offer my warm congratulations to all of you for this wonderful program on Marina Beach. My dear sisters, today we have taken an important pledge, Tamil Nadu pledge, Sabadam. Huh? Very important Sabadam today we have taken.
சகோதரிகளே, இன்றைக்கு ஒரு முக்கியமான சபதம் ஏற்றிருக்கிறோம், முக்கியமான உறுதிமொழியை ஏற்றிருக்கிறோம்.
But now only the Sahodari has taken the Sabadam.
Very good Sahodari, you have taken a good Sabadam.
But to make the pledge a reality, we have to get the Sahodara also to
now
take the pledge.
Now all the Sahodara
who are in the Marina Beach, we want them also to
now
take the Sabadam.
Now we have to,
after we go home, we have to ensure that in the four walls of our house also, we take this pledge.
Where's the paper? Hey, Amritam, give me the paper. Huh? Amritam, where's the Sabadam? Ah.
Now, all of you, each one of you, you take this Sabadam, you go to your house, you stand in front of the kitchen and you say, no dosa, no idli, no chutney, no rice. First, each and every sahodara in our own house has to take the Sabadam. And that is how a million pledges, that is what we decide today, a million pledges in every home in Tamil Nadu, they have to pledge no more violence. We want equal space for women in public areas and in the domestic
sphere. Is that correct?
Correct.
Will you read the pledge in your houses? Raise your hands.
கை தூக்குங்க, வீட்டுல போய் பண்ணுவாங்க.
Wonderful. Amritam, you make copies of all the pledge and give it to all the sisters. I am very happy to see so many of you have come here to this pledge-taking ceremony. I don't know how, because Modi ji sitting in Delhi has taken all our money away.
I thought to myself, I asked Vasuki, how the women will come? No money
and
is there.
Tomorrow, on November 28th, we must join the protest all over India to tell Modi ji, give us back our money. We are not begging you for your money. We want our money and we want our money now. No restrictions on our money.
My dear sisters,
you will be shocked to know that last year, in the year 2015, the National Bureau of Crime Research, which registers the crimes in India against women, they say that in 1 year, 3,27,000 cases of violence against women were registered in India. And out of those cases, 34,651 cases of rape were registered in 1 year. Every 15 minutes, a woman is raped in India. And of these rapes, the shame is 8,800 children were raped in India. That means out of all the rapes, more than one third of the rapes were against minors. What a shame
It is. My dear sisters, this is not only an assault on our bodies. It is a much wider attack on our right to live. And we say, if in India a woman does not feel safe, then we say there is no democracy in India. As long as a woman is unsafe in India, we do not believe that there can be a democracy.
Democracy does not mean only the right to
democracy
vote.
Means my equal right as a citizen
democracy
of India.
Democracy means the right of a schoolgirl to go to school without being stopped, without being afraid of violence
democracy
against her.
Democracy means that a woman worker can go to work without being afraid that the landlord will assault her, the contractor will assault her, the supervisor will assault her, the employer will support her. That is not democracy.
That is why, my dear sisters, we say the fight for a violence-free India, the fight for a safe and secure environment in India is a fight for the basic democratic rights of women. It is a fight for the basic citizenship rights.
But my dear sisters, we have many laws which we have
but
fought
today
for.
A culture is being created which makes and tries and makes those laws
the RSS, the Hindutva forces, in the name of tradition, in the name of history, they want to imprison women into upper caste ideologies.
They say, look at the clothes the girl was wearing.
This is not Indian culture.
It's a shame that RSS leaders should speak like that.
Our leaders also speak like that.
People, when a three-year-old child is raped, are you looking at the clothes she's
our
wearing?
Our movement challenges such cultures.
We say we have every right to dress the way we do. We have every right to speak the way we do. We have every right to go where we want to go. This is our democratic right. And in the name of tradition, don't try and imprison us in Manubhadi
cultures.
In our fight for a violence-free India, we fight against such cultures. At the same time, we fight against the caste system.
But at the same time, the caste system destroys basic democratic rights of Indian society.
You have heard about the honor killings. And Tamil Nadu has now become one of the most dangerous, the hot danger spot as far as honor killings is concerned.
And where are the Dravida parties?
Periyar's legacy.
பெரியாருடைய பாரம்பரியம் என்ன ஆனது?
Those who once fought against casteism.
எங்கே போயிருக்கிறார்கள் இன்றைக்கு?
Why their mouths are sealed? Why the tongue is paralyzed?
நாக்கு.
நாக்கு. Tied up. நாக்கு tied up.
நாக்கு கட்டி போட்டிருக்காங்க.
Why the நாக்கு is கட்டி
போட்டு? ஏன் நாக்கு கட்டி போடப்பட்டு இருக்கிறது?
Why? Because vote bank politics. The Dravida parties have forgotten their legacy, they have forgotten their tradition.
Today when one leader, yeah.
What is his name, Ramdas, PMK, what is this PMK, I don't know, is it a political party, is it a party which accepts the constitution of India? It is a shame that they are making the most disgusting, objectionable caste
system. They are inciting violence against Dalit
and inciting violence against those young couples who break the caste barrier.
Did you hear a single ADMK leader?
Did you hear a single DMK leader condemn such statements?
No, they will put trade union leaders in jail. They will put women leaders in jail. But they will never put Ramdas in jail because they themselves want to compromise with upper caste.
Therefore,
politics.
We say our fight against violence is equally a fight against the hated caste system.
My dear friends,
violence against women has many forms. One of the most virulent forms is that of communal
is an
violence.
An environment of hatred being created against Muslim
when a young
women.
Man who happens to be a Hindu or a young woman who happens to be a Hindu marries a Muslim man, then the RSS and the Hindutva Brigade call it love jihad.
When hundreds and thousands of new brides who happen to be Hindu are burned to death in their homes in dowry deaths, then the RSS and the BJP are silent.
And they do not remember women's rights.
But it is only to attack the Muslim community. It is only to take forward their hatred agenda, which is a communal agenda, that they want to use the issue of sexual assault.
Therefore, my dear sisters, our fight against violence is also a fight for secular values. Our fight against violence is also a fight for the rights of all women, regardless of their religion.
Our body.
Nobody has a right to decide about our body.
If we want to have one child, we'll have
one
child.
If we want to have two children, we will have two children.
If I want to have no children, I will have no
children. But today, the BJP MPs are saying the main job of Hindu women is to produce at least 10
children. They are taking away our jobs.
நம்முடைய வேலைகளை அவர்கள் பறித்துக் கொள்கிறார்கள்.
They are taking away our ration cards.
நம்முடைய ரேஷன் கார்டை பறித்துக் கொள்கிறார்கள்.
They are rising the prices.
விலையை ஏற்றி விடுகிறார்கள்.
They are making it impossible for us to live a life of dignity.
ஒரு கண்ணியமான வாழ்க்கை நடத்துவதற்கான சூழலை கொடுக்க மறுக்கிறார்கள்.
And they want us to produce 10 children.
ஆனால் நாம் 10 குழந்தைகளை பெற்றுக் கொடுக்க வேண்டும் என்று மட்டும் சொல்கிறார்கள்.
Let Modi ji produce 10 children.
முதல்ல மோடி வந்து 10 குழந்தைகளை பெற்றுக் கொடுக்கட்டும்.
Let the RSS practice what it preaches.
RSS பிரச்சாரம் செய்வதை முதலில் RSS தலைவர்கள் நடத்தி காட்டட்டும்.
No, we don't want that.
நமக்கு அதெல்லாம் வேண்டாம்.
We don't want little RSS பிரச்சாரர்ஸ் running around.
ஆமா, அவங்க ஒருவேளை நிறைய குழந்தைகளை பெற்றால் ஒவ்வொன்றும் RSS உடைய பிரச்சாரகராக மாறும். அது நமக்கு வேண்டாம்ப்பா.
So the point is this, that these cultures which they are trying to promote are cultures that we have to fight if we want a violence-free society.